Dash screen, and then we'll be moving on to services, and then finally we'll see media player API, right? So this will be the agenda for the day. Yes, so it's there. Now splash screen is a screen which will come for some time and then it will automatically go off. I think you would have seen in the applications. So let us try to create one new project. So I'm going to name the project as, just a moment. I'm going to say music app over here. So the name itself goes like music app. And then you say next, again next, and choose empty activity. Then say next. Now the name of my activity is not main activity. I'm just going to change it as splash activity. So I want that whenever the program will be executed, whenever my app will come, so splash activity is the first activity which will be coming into my application, right? So I'm going to say finish. Let the Gradle build the project. Alright, so here we are. So the layout file of my application is over here as in your constraint layout. So what I am going to do, I am just going to remove this text view from my layout file. And we got some splash screens. Let's see how the splash screen will look like. So it looks like this over here. So design one splash. So it's a Photoshop or it's a Coral Draw kind of a thing. So you design a rectangular image and it should not be very much high on disk size. I mean to say it should not be 3 MBs or 4 MBs or even in 1 MB or 2 MB size. It should be in KBs more or less. So this kind of an image we have to design, and after this, so I have one image, so I'll just take it. So I got this background.jpg. So it's over here if you can see one basic image. So let's do a Control Z. And I'm going to paste this image in my drawable. So do a Control V over here. And now in my constraint layout, I'm going to say the background of this guy is @drawable/background. So it means in my design part, this activity is looking like this. Makes a sense now? So you can design any UI of your choice. Yes, ma'am. So you need to copy the image in the drawable and then you come back to the layout file and you change the text, I mean change the background as in your @drawable/background, and your UI will automatically look like the way your background is. Now in my splash activity, I'm going to do a little bit of code. So I'm going to create a guy called handler, which is from android.os package. If you can see android.os. You say handler is a new handler, right? You put a semicolon. It's just an object construction of a handler. Now I'm going to write one anonymous class. So I will just say a function called handleMessage. So I'm going to delete this super statement. I got this guy called handleMessage. In my onCreate method, I'm saying handler.send the empty message delete. Now the ID of the message is 101 and the time is going to be 3000 as in milliseconds. So it's like 3 seconds. It means whenever my splash activity will be created, so it will be there for 3 seconds, and after 3 seconds it will send a message to the guy called handler. And now here I am checking in case the message dot what is equal to 101. Now what shall I do? We shall start a new activity. It's very basic. So we need to start a new activity thereafter. Now I'll just start the AVD in the background. So how we can create a new activity? So it's very basic. You come back here and you say right click and you say a new activity, and I'm going to name it as in I'm going to take it as an empty activity, and let's name it as main activity itself. It's gonna be main activity, and finally you can say finish. The expectation now. The expectation is my splash activity, once it's gonna receive this 101 as a message over here in the handler, so I will create a new intent. I will say intent as in a new intent. Source goes like your splash activity, and destination is your main activity, right? And then you can say start the activity with this intent. And after that, I'm going to call the finish method. It means that splash activity will be destroyed. So it will come, it will start a new activity, and it will be destroyed. So it's just a visual effect as of now for the user. But in reality, when to use splash? You use splash when you have to perform some internet access. Let's say you need to retrieve some deals from the server. So you'll show the splash to the user, and you will retrieve the data from the server in the background, so that the main activity can display some deals, something like that, right? So let us try to run the code. So AVD is already up, and see what will happen now. So I got my manifest file over here, which says that you got your splash activity as main and launcher. It means it will come for the first time, and the moment splash activity is launched, after 3 seconds you're gonna release a message 101, fire a message. On receival of message, we are going to start an activity. So let's see. So it's saying installing the APKs. So you can see one splash screen coming in. It's holding there for some time, and then you have launched your main activity. So it's the main activity as of now, which you can see, right? So let's try to see it once again. So here we are. So you got the splash activity, and after the splash activity, you will be navigated to the main activity. Anyone having any query how we did that? So in order to write your application as in your real-time project, so you can create some beautiful graphic as your first screen, which you can show it to your user. It will be really interactive, and it's gonna be, you know, enhancing the beautification, nothing else. So let's say WhatsApp has no splash. Facebook, it will not have splash, right? So even though if it will have a splash, it will wait for some time, it will go off because it's loading the data from the server. So you need splash screens in order to load the data from the server, so that user can hold for some time. Other than that, it's just the beautification of your application. Anyone having any query how to create a splash screen, guys? Great.